Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Matt, and I'm back with Kerbal Space Program Hard Career Mode. This time, we are going to adjust the flight paths of the craft we sent out last episode. At least that's part of the plan for today. Off-camera, I sent a satellite on the roughly on the polar orbit. However, I needed two attempts for that. I kinda messed up in the first attempt, and that means that we got some debris over here, which is actually a full probe, but it won't deorbit. It's out of fuel and it's not in the orbit that is needed. So yeah, the next thing that is going to happen is the Kerlington Kerbin 1 that is approaching the maneuver node. So that's what we are going to take care of. Now it might help if I turn the craft in the direction that we need to burn. This. And the plan is to get our apoapsis out to where it's supposed to be. Additionally, I've set the Gagarin 2. Oops, how do we do that? The Gagarin 2 is currently on an orbit around the moon, and the thing is it's entered that moon orbit below the moon, then passed in front of the moon, and I had to accelerate to get it to where what's happening to it now, to get it into a Kerbin orbit with a periapsis below 30,000 meters, I think. But something's off with it right now. I'm thinking it just switched SOI, and for some reason it's not recalculating it. I have to take care of that after we do the burn. I'm really hoping we got enough fuel left. Yeah, approaching the maneuver node. But I think we should be fine. Okay, let's try it like this. Oh no, there. Okay, that works. At least I hope it does. Yeah, we are at 11,300. We might actually... Okay, this already counts as hitting the target orbit. What? Okay. Right. You have successfully deployed our satellite into equatorial orbit around Kerbin. Okay. I was expecting to need another adjustment near the apoapsis, but if that's all, that's all. So we got our first satellite contract done. And I think I'll leave that satellite here until it, yeah, eventually probably hits the moon. Although currently the closest approach is 2 days out, and then the moon will be on the other side of Kerbin. Oh well. Well, I might add a maneuver to get it to get it back in a bit. This way we shouldn't hit the moon. Okay, that's 4 days out. Oh. Okay, no. Focus around the moon. Ah, there we are. And there we are. We are in a somewhat inclined orbit. We are 5 minutes from SOI change. Okay. Oh, I forgot something. Where is it right now? Oh no. I was thinking I forgot to... What? I forgot to deorbit my probe, or actually, I'll talk about it in a few. There we are. With a periapsis of 24 kilometers. That works. That works! And we would need to pay attention to it in about a day. So it's another day before... Alarm began 2, yes, raw time alarm 1 day. It's about a day before Jeb and I keep forgetting her name. Before Jeb and Terry are coming back. Oh, and it's nice to see that Terry isn't as panicky anymore. She was panicking off camera when I was adjusting the flight path. Yeah, and I was in an orbit past the moon and I had to accelerate to get my periapsis down. My Kerbin periapsis. And I was wondering why that happened. And then I realized that while I was moving in relation to the moon left, that meant my orbit goes around counterclockwise. Yeah, just as the moon's orbit. And that means I have to accelerate in a clockwise direction. No. Wait, now I have to... Yes, in a clockwise direction to bring down my periapsis, which was in the with the path I was flying actually accelerating my moon orbit, which was clockwise. So, live and learn. Okay, the other thing... Picked the wrong craft. I actually wanted the Leopard 2 probe. Which is actually not the Leopard 2 probe, or the Leopard 2. Well, it is the Leopard 2, it is the launcher, the orbital stage of the Rockamex Kerbin Polar. And yeah, as you can see, it is in orbit, it still has a little fuel left. The thing is, I got into an orbit, or I had a periapsis of about, yeah, not exactly 100 kilometers, but close. And an apoapsis of 600 and of about 600 kilometers. When I thought, well, it's time to drop the orbital stage. So I did exactly that, and then accelerated the satellite alone. And when with the fuel that was still left, or actually most of it is still left in the orbital stage, that's why I put in a probe core, I brought down my periapsis to 40 kilometers, which means this craft is going to deorbit soon. That means I'm not littering as much. I found out that the tail fins are actually better than the Delta Deluxe winglets that I was using last episode to keep the craft straight. I also found out that I was a bit short on fuel, which is why one of the probes, there it is, or there it isn't, why one of the probes is now marked as debris. I was a bit short on fuel, so I added a pair of, no, four boosters. And of course on ascent I realized that I had messed up my staging, because when the first pair of boosters ran empty, I tried to do asparagus staging again. I didn't drop the empty boosters, I uncoupled the full boosters, which meant they went upwards past my craft. Good thing is I only had the little drone on top, so there was no collision and nothing got damaged. Well, except for the boosters, they collided just above my craft, but that's alright. I still made it into orbit, and I am a bit optimistic that I can actually make the target orbit with the liquid fuel I still have left. It's going to take a while, but I think I can do it. Now, for my next trick. No, this is the correct one. Very good. For our next trick, we are grabbing the Savage Garden and a pilot. Who's going to be our pilot? Actually, I want someone who has a high level of experience, so I think I'm going to take Gamzy Kerman. And other than the description of the Savage Garden says, we are not going to the moon and back. We are editing this craft. Yeah, I thought so. I wasn't sure if I had exchanged the winglets already. And I haven't. Good thing I decided to change the craft. There we are. Tail fin. No, we still need one more. There we are. There we are. Those get dropped first, then those get dropped, and this, okay, the rest is okay. So, save it. We got those things. Alright. So, as I said, Gamzy Kerman. Bit of wobble here, but that's alright. Okay, SAS on. Fine control. And we launch it. Again. Okay, there we are. I want to adjust my heading a bit so we actually stay on the 90 degree marker. Degree. Actually, it's not that necessary now, I realize. Because we are not going to the moon. Jemsy is panicking. We are sending this lander right after the probe we launched last episode. Which is to say, we will be going or heading for Minmus. We are at an orbital velocity, which is nice. Let's make it 75, that's okay. Sufficient. Over there is where we will go. Pale white or blue dot. No, actually I think it was supposed to be green. Now if it is there, it should be... No, that's Ike. There it is. We set that one as our target. And of course we've got a descending node, which means we have to... Which direction do we have to burn? Ah, okay, now I know. And of course that means we are currently... our orbit is not exactly the way we need it, but that's okay. We'll figure something out. Oops, yeah, like this. This, because for the time being we're just circularizing our orbit, and when that is done, well, mostly, we're also doing a little adjustment on our nodes, ascending and descending, but that's not the primary goal just now. Nice, but if it doesn't, we aren't in much trouble. Ok, Okay, there we are. Ech. Okay, there we are. We will have to burn in a normal direction, mostly. It's too much. Like this. It's a problem. Those nodes. You can adjust the maneuver node, but when doing so, you have to keep in mind or pay attention to not this way. To not miss the node, especially when you're doing it so close ahead of yourself. Or so close to your current orbital position. Okay, that works. That's close enough. Yeah. 0.0, 0.0. There we go. Okay, where do we have the planet? Or the moon, actually. There it is. We sent this one out there. So we should be going burning around here, I guess. Should we? A bit late, isn't it? This. Okay, try that again. Oops, that was what? Oh, right. Like this, we are burning for a Kerbin escape trajectory, which is not what we want. Not yet. Okay, like this. With this, we would be hitting the moon on the way back. Okay. That's a weird thing. Ah, is Minmus in an eccentric orbit? That could be the case. Or I'm just burning way too far. That could also be the case. Oops. Ah, oops. Okay, like this. We should pretty much hit Minmus with this. Yeah, I thought so. Okay, well, that's a weird thing. So basically, we would be, you know, we would be using too much thrust with this. Basically what we're doing is add a little more. It was a little too much, I think. Yeah, like this, I think. That should do it. And if we focus on Minmus... Oh no, that would mean a very... a very short... encounter. I'm not sure that would actually... Yeah, that's better. I wasn't sure that with the shorter encounter we would have been able to actually get him in Miss Orbit. Okay, now how do I focus on Kerbin again? Not like this. That's a bit of a... Ah, there we go. We just need to... No, I don't want to focus on the moon. Maybe it's easier to focus on the moon first. And then we are closer to Kerbin and should be able to focus it. There we are. Okay, so we got 5 minutes to our maneuver, which is fine. Oh, it might be a good idea to actually get ourselves pointed in the correct direction. Just, you know, as an idea. Now it's telling me we need 30 seconds. So I'm just gonna see about starting the burn at half thrust when we are 30 seconds out. And if that doesn't, if that isn't correct, we just... Oh! Yeah, 40 seconds. We need full thrust. Because I actually kind of missed my burn. Like this, and we're going to check what our orbit actually looks like now. Focus view. Perfect! 1.2 million meters. That should actually get us where we want to be. Where we want to go. Yeah, there's a load of lines over here. Now we can actually unset Minmus as our target, because this way we will encounter Minmus in 5 days. I will add an SOI alarm. Yeah, okay, that's all right. So the satellite we sent out last episode will arrive in 5 days and 2 hours, or about 3 hours. And the Savage Garden that was launched several hours after the satellite will get there only 1 hour later. That's nice. I think we can actually do that, all of that next episode. Now, what I still got planned for this episode is... weird. Is not switched to the wreckage of the Savage Garden. That was not part of the plan. Trias Point, and all the debris. No, what I wanted is another savage garden. I need to rename those things, I think. Because I parked this one in moon orbit off camera, and we are coming up on a crater, it seems. Can we actually hit that? If we burn like this, well, we might need to... No, actually, maybe a bit like this, but that should do it. That should do it! Nice. Yeah, and you can see the way I modified the Savage Garden off camera before last episode. Let me just get ready for my burn. And then we got a couple seconds to talk about the Savage Garden. Is I replaced the fuel tank. That was a big one. Now it's it was an FLT 800, now it's a 400. And I added another science lab. No, not science lab, what was it called? Science Junior Materials Bay. I always mix those two up. I exchanged the battery pack for battery packs for a battery bank, and I need to... No, I don't need to burn yet. Installed a couple solar panels, installed a couple radiators. I'm not sure I need that, but yeah, better to have them and not need than to not have and need. Almost missed my burn again. I'm good at that kind of thing. Missing the burn, it is. Okay. Now we are over the far side east crater. Yeah, I think something like that. Oh, I can have CRC get out of the pod and check. Ooh, moon silent craters. I don't think we got that before. So we grab that. But what I actually wanted to check is where we are now. Moon's east far side crater. Okay. Board. Okay. I thought I already had that. Moon's east far side crater. Moon's canyons. The materials study and moon silent craters. Okay, odd. Yeah, the canyons is actually this area. That's a canyon going out of this crater. And I did an EVA report off camera for that area. Now, oops, is not exactly... Ah, when CRT got out, SAS was deactivated. I want to shed some horizontal velocity. Okay. That tears it for our booster stage. Or stages. Now I have to admit, theoretically, that one should have lasted us almost until we are down on the moon. I'm not sure if I've over-engineered the craft enough. Okay, it's time to get ready for the approach to the moon. Let's see, where are we going to come down? Hopefully not in a small crater, but it might happen. So I think I'm going to burn horizontally a bit. Okay, we have already switched to surface, which is nice. 10,000 meters, so let me get to about 100 meters per second. Actually, let me burn a bit slowly. Actually, let me get down to about 50. We are going to, what's the word? Accelerate again. But okay, those were our boosters. So much for them. Yeah, but I hope we don't accelerate too much. But I also don't want to use more than half our fuel, because that would mean we aren't going to get back into moon orbit, and that will mean we aren't going to get back to Kerbin. Okay, not getting back to Kerbin is not that much of a problem. We can always send a rescue mission, but I actually want this one to get into moon orbit, so the rescue mission doesn't have to land if it's needed. Okay, that's actually close enough for now. Oops, that was a bit... might have been a bit too much. Actually, let's just... very slowly... we are still accelerating, which is not exactly the way I want to land. We're still a ways up, so still alright. Don't want to hit the ground with more than 10 meters per second, because I think that's the impact velocity for the landing legs. And I also don't want to accelerate too much while we are... okay. And we're down! We're on the ground! We're on the moon! Not much by ways of bouncing. We can turn on our lights. No, I keep forgetting the key for the lights. Which looks like this. Can we? Oh no. In the VAB you can adjust the color value of the lights. I wondered if I could do that on the fly. But it seems I can't, so... okay. And while we're here, we observe the mystery goo. It seems to be less dense here. Keep that data. We can do a crew report. And actually transmit that home. Which also means we are getting a contract. Science data from surface of the moon. 32,000 funds, 2 science, in addition to those from the crew report. And we are... are we currently gathering electric charge? Yes, we are. We are, which is exactly what I wanted to happen. The solar panels are a bit weak, but that's okay. We did the mystery goo observation. We didn't observe the materials bay yet. You leave the sample bay doors open on the moon and go do something else for a while. That's giving us 60 science when we get it back. So we keep that data as well. We have a thermometer over here, so we log the temperature. Collected and recorded temperature data from the environment. We don't transmit that either. We can check the stored data. This is an EVA report that we can transmit. This is another EVA report that we are also transmitting. We keep that, and this is yet another EVA report. That should... I'm not sure it transmitted everything correctly. We'll find out, we'll find out. What we're doing now is actually we can send CRC on EVA. SAS disengaged? Was it still engaged? Okay. Now we got a very important question. Okay. I really need to invest in an actual lander with ladders and all that good stuff. Okay, at some point. I'm not going to plant a flag yet. I'm just going to get the EVA report. You look up and search the sky for Kerbin. Suddenly you feel very small. We are on the far side of the moon, which means you don't find Kerbin anywhere around here. So, yeah. But I wanted to go back to the Space Center. Because we can recover some debris. The launch clamps. And accept another contract to plant a flag on the moon. It's going to give us about 100,000 funds for doing something we were going to do anyways. Oh, it tests the flea at the launch site for 3,000 funds. That would be a short fun mission, I think. Just for old time's sake. Yeah, the thing is with the satellite and the rocket going to Minmus right now. I think... How much time do we have left? Okay, 4 years. I think I will see if there's a contract to get a Minmus orbit before I actually get that Minmus orbit. We should have enough time for doing that. So now that we got the contract, it's time for us to... got too many craft. I need to get rid of some of them. I think I can... Well, the main problem is all the relics and pods and... Actually, no, there are several... Oh, heh! Yeah, we didn't watch that one. We didn't wait for this one to deorbit, that means it's gone around another time. Well, that's alright. We got 4 probes, we got no base. Yeah, no base, 1 EVA, 4 flags, but they aren't shown. 11 debris and 13 ships. And only 3 of those, I think, aren't scrap or shipwrecks. That's a problem, I haven't switched those wrecks or the capsules from the rescue missions to debris. We actually got the Gagarin 2 holding Jeb and Terry. We got the Savage Garden that is currently empty, with which Theothy landed on the moon. And we got another... Actually, this one is the one Tria landed with. And this one is Theothy's craft. Then we got a third Savage Garden, which is the one going to Minmus with Gamzee. And then of course we got Siathy, and we are going to fly her. Okay! Now it realizes it still has some stuff to transmit, so it did so. Okay, we are going to... Actually, let's see... Yeah, we are going to just plant a flag here. And that's Siathy's landing on the moon. I think... No, I'll leave that to a later mission. Oh, actually, yeah, I'll leave that to a later mission. Now, with the EVA report done and the flag planted, we can actually send Siathy back to the lander. Gotta take care not to tip it over. There we are! And the lander's still upright, which is good. Just for fun, we are turning SAS back on, just in case. So the flag has been planted, we got 70,000 funds for something we were going to do anyways. We are at 740,000 now. Okay, I'm not sure, am I going to take Siathy back right now? Actually, I could observe the mystery goo again, just for a little bit, for a little more science. Nah. Or will I? Yes, yes. I'll just keep that data and. No, actually, I can't keep it. I can't, because I'm going to take all the experiments from the container and the Science Junior, and I already did that here, and put them in the command pod once I'm back in space. And you can't add the same experiment twice, so I would have to throw one of them away anyways. Actually, I can review stored data and transmit that one home as well. And we keep the material study. Alright, so I'll leave this one to charge a bit. Or how are we looking time-wise? Okay. I always press M in the Space Center view to get to the... what's it called? To the map view. But that doesn't work. Yeah, that was the... this. We don't need this alarm. At least not right now. I am wondering if we are going to pass close enough. No, we aren't. At some point I'm just going to have a station in orbit and do the crew report from there. Something I'm seeing happen. About 3 hours time. Okay. So we got the polar satellite in about half an hour. Not sure if I'm going to do this in this episode, but I think so. Yeah. Weird. Just gonna check if maybe we have a little... Heh! Test the small landing gear landed at the Kerbin. Test the mainsail at the launch... The mainsail! Ooh. That would be fun. To launch a craft with the mainsail installed. I don't yet know where to send it. Well, when we get Cethe back from the moon, we can send someone else there. So that would work. The small landing gear. We could do that with a science flight, actually. The flea at the launch site, just for old time's sake, is 4,000 funds. And we had the Landart, which is deprecated, but it's 3,000 funds. Actually, we could modify the Landart to remove the goo containers and maybe put in a decoupler. So we're only getting the capsule back, not the... On the other hand, the parachute can hold the whole craft, so we could also use use the Landart as is, without a decoupler. I'll think about it. For now, I wanted to get Cethe back into orbit. Orbiting Kerbin? No. Landed at the moon, yes. I was wondering why it has a higher mission time, but of course I've launched that off camera. It was around the moon before I even started the episode. Okay, let's see, which way do we have to burn? Actually, we could do it the way I did it with the Gagarin 2 and burn west. To get into a clockwise orbit, so we can burn near the moon to already get a low apoapsis around Kerbin. I think I'm going to do that. SAS is on. So all aboard who want to come aboard. We are leaving this place. Time to put in our gear. Well, I'm not sure I'm actually getting my apoapsis high enough. I don't want to impact the crater rim. Let's see where we are. Yeah, that should do it for the time being. was our sun exposure looking? This? Yeah, that should do it. Should be good enough. That should be enough for an orbit. In 2 minutes we're gonna circularize it, and then we will do a full moon orbit before we start on our way back. Is this okay? That's the one going to Mimnus. Okay, there we are, and burn. There we are. Okay, 13 kilometers by 25, yeah, that's good. Okay, now we are a bit low on fuel, but that should be fine. And we're going to add a maneuver around... Oops, that was a bit much, I think. Or was it? Actually, no. On the other hand... Yeah, we need to do it a good deal earlier. And this would get us right through the crust, which is not what you want to happen. Okay, like this. That's about the best we can get. 200 kilometers, 164, 87, 53, that's already in atmosphere, 43, 29, yeah, that's good enough. Provided we still have the 300 meters per second delta V we need for that. Guess we'll find out at some point. But not right now. Okay, we got our orbital velocity of about 600 on, let's say, 100. Not much more than what we have left, so we should be fine. We should be fine. No. Now, what did I say? The flea, for all times, for old times' sake. We'll accept that. And the mainsail, because we want to learn stuff. Oops. Now, we need the Vanguard. Oops. Funny how tiny this craft is. I mean, I got satellites that are bigger than that. Or that aren't much smaller than that. That was a first craft. Whoa, what? Okay, a pair of goo canisters, yeah, is 1600 funds, which is why I wanted to remove them. N Now who's going to fly this thing? Oh, one of our scientists can do that. Let's take Dutry. Just gonna save it like this actually. Actually, carbon launch site, yeah, the fuel booster. And let's just see how this thing goes. Ooh, I think I had it set to full thrust. Yep, I still had it set to full thrust. Well, that's something we learned. Wee, it's tilting over to the left. Oh right. No SAS modules. Whoops. No, I don't remember. I don't remember if the whole... if I'd done the lawn dart before the overhaul, but no, it doesn't seem so. What? Okay, so it seems I had done the lawn dart before the aero overhaul, which is a bit of a nasty surprise, especially for Dutry. Crap it. Son of a crap. Yeah. Great, I got... yeah, okay, Space Center. So what do we learn? But that means... that means that the first rocket you can build in career mode will actually crash. I need to test that. I need to test that. I'm gonna do that off camera. But yeah, the apparently after the overhaul, or maybe I had I got one reputation, but I think I lost quite a bit because Dutry died. Now I can check something else. Ah, because it was still set to 500, and if you add a new parachute... it will be set to 1000. Because in the aero overhaul, the parachutes were reworked to open at an altitude of 1000 meters rather than 500. And if you've got craft that were saved or were created before the aero overhaul in 1.2, I think there was some stuff they did with the parachutes and stuff, then they are still saved with the opening value of 500 meters, and that's not high enough for the parachute to slow down the craft enough. That counts as a TLOV. Tragic loss of vehicle. question is, do we get Steltrid or Burkus Kerman back? I'm not yet sure. I'm going to rescue one of those two, maybe Burkus. Maybe, yes, yes, that's the idea. That's the actual idea. We are... We grabbed the... No, we have to... Well, we can load that. Ooh, that thing looks terrible. Going to just copy this. Oops, doesn't matter. Don't save. We are going to grab the Savage Garden. That's it. Altitude is set to 1000. We are going to grab the Savage Garden and save it. Rescue me one again. Thunk. Yeah, that's alright. This is kind of annoying. Although I could just as well undo. And that should... Yep, that looks good. Now, what I wanted to do with this is grab those radiators. Remove those things. Remove all the science parts. And we're going to add an inline cockpit. Oops. Okay, that works. Nah. Add the radiators again. Looks a bit like a space fighter. And what did I want to add as well? I wanted to add some more... is where the parachutes are. Yeah, it's looking good. Now I just want to check. I got a thermometer, but I don't actually need that. This is a pure rescue craft. We got all of this. Currently trying to figure out the delta V values for this thing. What else do we need? Engine. We wanted to use the mainsail engine. That thing is crazy. I got what's it called? The delta V calculation open in on the other comp. And the problem is I don't remember what I set, what the values actually are. Thrust 1379 thrust. That's crazy. Might be a tiny little bit crazy. Consumption is 44.407. Okay, this is calculated. This also is... Oops. This is... Holy... moly! Whoa. Whoa. So in theory, this craft, if we just put in the mainsail, this whole thing is going to get to the moon twice. No, actually, no, it's just putting the... Oh, yeah, the orbital stage alone would get us to the moon. Let's put it like this. And I think I'm going to try that actually. That I want to see. No utility. No, where was it? Structural was where it was. Oh, I got the struts. Yeah, the orbital stage alone would get us halfway to the moon. Question is how much thrust did it have? Where was it? There it is. 1300. That means we could lift 137 tons. Oh, we would hit our mass restriction before we, or shortly after we get the point where the mainsail can't lift us anymore. Whoa! That's a bit crazy. Now how would... Oh wait, is that the medium tank? Ah, right! Right. I've listed this tank as a medium tank. The X-232, because there is an orange tank that is as big as two of the of those tanks. Yeah, that should get us pretty much to the moon. Now I'm wondering if maybe I'll still add the science parts. At least one materials bay and a pair of goo containers. Yeah, it should be enough, I think. Should work. Where is the science junior and a pair of goo containers? Of course a thermometer as well, and we still got the antenna. Now getting this thing back from the moon will be another question, but we should make it there. Okay, time to save it. And... this is crazy. It's crazy enough to... might be crazy enough to work. Actually, I want this to work with these, this... and then this. Okay. And who hasn't been to the moon yet? Valentina hasn't been to the moon. She only had a flyby. No, I was just thinking about putting a second inline cockpit, but that would probably make the craft too heavy on re-entry. Which is something I want to avoid. Also thinking about removing the radiator panels, but or actually just moving them somewhere else, but I don't know where, so I think I'll leave it as is. Now we got a thrust to weight ratio of roughly 3, so I think we want to launch with half thrust. There is Valentina. Okay, she's in this cockpit. That's good. How did we get out of here? C? Yeah, C. Okay, let's launch. Okay. Okay, we're launching a bit slower than I would have feared. It's still pretty fast for two-thirds thrust, I think, but... not as fast as it could be. And we're burning through fuel quite fast, so I think here I might have messed up something in my calculation. We're already at half fuel. That's odd. Ooh. We're also very fast. A bit fast for the altitude at which we are. But it's alright as long as we get to orbit on the orbital stage. We should be fine. Oops. That's good enough. Yeah, it's not working as great as advertised. Oh well. We don't have to land on the moon. If we don't have enough fuel for it, we'll just call it a rain check and then just get back. Just rescue, who was it? What's his face? But here we are, so Burkas. Okay. Ooh. Yep. Ooh, orbital stage isn't even enough for orbit. That's not a good sign. It means I've messed up my calculation somewhere. Don't yet know where. But actually it looks like it should check out. Maybe the mass... yeah, I failed to put in the correct mass for the engine. Do we learn? Before you launch, always check your mass is correct. But hey, at least I didn't mess up feet and meter. Was it meters or... Yeah, I think it was feet and meters. So... That's something that happened to NASA, I think. With a lander or a probe for Mars. No, I wanted to set this as my target. They ended up impacting Mars because someone had failed to account for... I think they had a probe that was built in Europe and was using meters as a matter of course for distance measurements and speed as well, I think, meters per second, and they hadn't taken that into account when it came to, you know, doing the actual landing, which led to them, to the probe hitting the planet a bit harder than expected, or the atmosphere, I'm not sure which. At least that's the story that goes around about this particular project. I don't know how correct that is, but it's something that can happen. Shouldn't, but it can. You all know Murphy. Okay, like this. Yeah, it's weird that that mainsail should still have gotten us into orbit. Oh well. Where are we going to go? Realizing this episode is actually even longer than the last. That was already one where I thought, well, you should have cut it a bit earlier. But I think I'm going to do a bit more stuff, and that is at least adjust my orbital inclination for getting to the moon. Oh, we're going to end up littering again. Because we're going to drop the three boosters in space. Oh well, can't be helped. At least they will be marked as debris from the start. Actually, when we are here, we should be burning around here. Nope, actually we should be burning a bit later. And we should be burning a good deal less. Okay, 1700. Oops, that was a bit... not enough. Not enough mana. Okay, we'll take that. 2 million meters. So... Hey. Wait, which savage garden is that? Okay, I think I can skip that alarm. Where's the satellite? Okay, so everything's gonna be happening all at once. No, wait. I need to turn around. TomTom, turn around. This way. Ah, okay. Time warp is coming up. Maneuver node is coming up for the Savage Garden, which is going to make things a bit interesting, because now I'm going to be in a bit of a hurry. Okay, 30 seconds. So that means we're going to burn right about now. Ah, crap. Hadn't taken into account that my boosters would run out. So, of course, once again, I am burning a bit late. Story of my gaming. I was about to say story of my life, but only in this game. I have to admit, I'm wondering where the moon is right now. I thought it would come over the horizon during our burn, but it doesn't seem to be doing so. I don't recall destroying it. Ah, there we are! Okay, so basically you need to burn for the moon just before it's... Oh, crumbs. Now everything is throwing an alarm. So first off, we are not close enough to the moon yet. Shh, crap. Okay, like this. Then we get the wrong craft. We wanted this. Yeah, we're already past our burn, but that's okay. We should still be fine, mostly. I mean, sure, I could have waited another orbit. Okay. There we are. Heh, there's Burgess Heap. Almost collect him already. Oh, crumbs! A periapsis of a kilometer. That's way too low. That's way too low. Oops, that's way too high again. Come on. Next thing to do will be the satellite. And I'm finally going to call this an episode. Okay, that's it. So I'm just going to add an SOI alarm and switch to this one. And I don't seem to have set up maneuver node, which is odd, to say the least. Oops. Okay, like this. Okay, that should take care of that. It's on node 3.8. So I'm thinking about a quick little burnabout here. Ish. Actually, it could be done a bit earlier, I suppose. Yeah, that's looking better. In about half an hour, it works. 47 meters per second delta V to get us aligned correctly. I think I'm going to do that off camera as well. Okay, and that's it for today. No, actually it isn't yet, not completely. One more thing. Actually two more things. Some more debris. Actually, how much... Okay, no. I was wondering if we can upgrade the R&D facility, but we can't. Okay, the small landing gear landed at Kerbin. Accept that contract. And... grab the box top 2. We need a pilot. That's going to be... Tria. A scientist. No, actually first we put in the engineer. Didn't I have... Yes, Bill as an engineer, and then we're going to put, we're gonna put Bob in as our scientist. Now we're on the landing, on the runway. Time to turn on the brakes and run the test. Which gives us 1 science, 2,000 funds. And I'm going to leave the craft right here as it is on the runway. I am going to fly it off camera to try once more to get this EVA report. Should be the third attempt or so I'm using on this, but... what? No, I wanted to check. Okay, I'm not gonna launch right away. I think I'm going to wait until I've checked in on the Orbital Genius again. Off camera, I will adjust the... what's it called? The orbit of the Rocomex, of the Kerbin, of the Polar satellite. Check on the Savage Garden, which is coming back from the moon. Check on the Savage Garden that is going to the moon, but that should be a later alarm actually. Check on the Orbital Genius for the crew report from space. And I'm going to bring the Gagarin 2 in. Next episode we are going to adjust the... actually I'm not sure, I might do that off camera as well. Adjust the apoapsis of the Kerlington satellite. And the next episode we are actually going to explore Minmus. With the Staedtler Minmus 1 and the Savage Garden going to Minmus. So... until next time then, I hope it won't be quite as long an episode, because we should be around an hour and a half again. But yeah, I hope the next episode is closer to the 1 hour mark than the last two were. So until then, thank you and good night.